there is no one person in charge.
There's always been a very strong tradition of equality and egalitarianism amongst Quakers, and that's why we don't have hierarchies, because at the core of that is the belief that everybody is equal before God.
It's quite an unusual experience, I think, for many of us to come into a community where there isn't a hierarchy, where everyone is equally valued.
We have an array of committees, and it's very unlikely that if you're a Quaker, you won't be on a committee. There are committees for everything.
So there is no one person in control. It's the people, the members of the society who run it.
Nobody stays in a committee for too long. We rotate regularly. So there's an evenness about it, which is an enormous strength, because there's a fairness and a distribution of the work. So it works very well.
I think it's a very good place to practice powerlessness, which is, after all, if at the heart of the Christian message and Christian symbolism, that powerlessness, whether it's in the form of the crucifixion or the incarnation, and Jesus' whole teachings about, turn the other cheek, and if somebody asks you to go with you a mile, go with him too. The whole of that central notion about who holds power and the corruptive effect of power, I think is very interestingly investigated inside Quakerism, and it is an experiment, a practice of handing power over to God.
The Quaker Business Meeting is a lengthy process, but an extremely effective process. The meeting does not vote. If there's a particular issue, there's no voting. We have to come to a sense of the meeting, which is not a consensus.
The clerk reflects the sense of the meeting. The clerk does not direct. He can interpret. He can help. And the meeting can help him, especially when it comes to writing the minute.
A good clerk enables the community to speak their minds and to together come to decisions.
The experience of inclusion is very interesting, that no point of view is excluded, and so it all contributes to final, what emerges, one could say, as a decision.
It sometimes takes a little bit longer to make a decision, but the decision that's reached is fair and proper. So at the end of a decision-making process, which we call discernment, everybody is satisfied. So in other areas, somebody may go away disgruntled that they haven't got their way. That doesn't happen in a Quaker meeting. We can have a silence where we contemplate the question that's being considered, and that may take some time, and then have a talk about the decision to be reached. And if there's still a difference of opinion, then another period of discernment will take place, and another period of quietness and discussion until everybody in the room agrees with the decision.
Voting, unfortunately, means that those who win the vote are satisfied, but those who don't win the vote are dissatisfied and unhappy and won't accept it, and they try and work against it and bring it all up again. Whereas with the Quaker meeting, it's there, and if the sense is taken correctly and people behaving correctly as friends, it'll come to a resolution in that meeting, and it won't have to come up again. It'll be done.